Let it be Christmas everywhere, in the hearts of all people, both near and afar. Christmas everywhere. Feel the love of the season wherever you are, on a small country road lined with green mistletoe, big city streets where a thousand lights glow. And let it be Christmas everywhere. Heavenly music fill the air. Let every heart sing and every bell ring the story of hope and joy and peace. Let it be Christmas everywhere. Let heavenly music fill the air. Let anger and fear and hate disappear. And let there be love that lasts through the year. Let it be Christmas. Christmas everywhere. Let it be Christmas everywhere. With the gold and the silver, the green and the red. Christmas everywhere. In the smiles of all children asleep in their beds, in the eyes of young babies, their first falling snow. Elderly's memories that never grow old. Let it be Christmas everywhere. Let heavenly music fill the air. Let every heart sing, every bell ring, a story of hope and joy and peace. Let it be Christmas everywhere. Let heavenly music fill the air. Let anger and fear hate disappear. Let there be love that lasts through the year. Let it be Christmas, Christmas everywhere. Let it be Christmas everywhere. In the songs that we sing and the gifts that we bring, Christmas everywhere. And what this day means and what we believe, from the sandy white beaches where blue waters roll, snow-covered mountains and valleys below. Let it be Christmas everywhere. Let heavenly music fill the air. Let anger and fear and hate disappear. Let there be love that lasts through the years. Let it be Christmas, Christmas everywhere, Christmas everywhere.
Oh, stop it. Stop. I'm starting to feel a little bit better, so I was able to get that one out. Good morning. Welcome to Franklinton Baptist Church. Man, this side of the church starting, well, no, it's kind of even this morning. Usually one side's leaning to the other, but y'all have evened it out pretty good this morning. How's everybody doing? Well, good. Well, stand up then. If you're feeling good, go ahead and stand up. 82. Page 82 if you're following along. If you're lazy, there it is.
With us.
this morning. You may be seated.
I'm going to ask all the children to come gather around the candles this morning. This is the second Sunday of Advent, and we're going to light what is called the Love Candle or the Bethlehem Candle. Like the Hope Candle, the Bethlehem Candle is purple, signifying repentance and royalty. This candle helps us recall the preparation of Mary and Joseph as they made before the birth of Jesus Christ, as they traveled from Nazareth to Bethlehem for the first population census in order to fulfill the prophecy of the words of Micah the prophet when he said, "But ye, O Bethlehem, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from old and from ancient times." So this morning we light the Bethlehem candle, the love candle, one of the purple candles. So let's pray together. Thank you, children, for being here this morning. It is a great group of looking children and young people. Lord, thank you for love. God is love. Jesus is love. He loved us. You loved us so much, God, that you gave us your only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Your love was manifested through a babe who was born in a manger in Bethlehem. And as we gather here together on this morning in December, as we remember that Christmas is about love, it is about Jesus, we thank you for these children, these young people and their leaders. Lord, we love you and thank you for loving us. Thank you for this church and its people. And Lord, as we gather together today, we shall never forget the most precious gift ever given, that of your Son, Jesus Christ. And it's in his name we pray. Amen. Thank you, young people. You may be seated. Well, good morning. We're glad to see you this morning. We welcome you to Franklinton Baptist Church. And if you're visiting with us this morning, we especially welcome you to the Little White Church. All your announcements are in your bulletin. I don't have to make all those announcements. The biggest announcement is something special happening this afternoon, but I forgot what it was. Do y'all know what it is? What is it?
A Christmas play.
A Christmas play. That's right. What time?
5 o'clock.
Where at?
FCC.
At the FCC. What's the FCC? Franklinton Community Center. Where's that located? Across the street. Man, I'm glad y'all got all the answers. Okay, 5 o'clock across the street at the Franklin Community Center, and y'all are having a play? Is it going to be good? It's going to be great, isn't it? I can't wait to see the play at 5 o'clock this afternoon across the street at the Community Center. Is it going to be funny?
Yeah.
All right. So I hope all of you will attend 5 o'clock this afternoon across the street at Community Center. We're going to have a Christmas play involving all of our children and young people. It's called A Very Mixed Up Christmas Pageant. I bet it will be a mixed up Christmas pageant. Bring some cookies if you can bring some cookies. We're going to share some cookies, bring some lemonade or drink. And we're just going to have a great time. I hear Santa Claus may show up this afternoon. So it's just going to be a great time. They've been working on this since September. And so we can't wait to see what's going to happen this afternoon at 5 o'clock. All the other announcements are in your bulletin. This Tuesday at 6 o'clock will be the last Takeaway Tuesday until after the first of the year. So if your kids have been coming to Takeaway Tuesdays, make sure they're here for this Takeaway Tuesday. It's a special Takeaway Tuesday, and so have them here, but this will be the last one until after school starts back in January, okay? And you know all the other announcements. The red envelopes are in the back for the Happy Birthday Jesus, and the Share His Love business cards are in the back. You know all about those. So pick one up. Make sure you give Jesus something on his birthday this year at Christmas time, and then his Share His Love envelopes. Reverse Advent calendar, if you're helping Olivia with that, those items are due by next Sunday. Deacon staff Christmas party this Saturday at 5 o'clock over in the community center. Any other announcements?
All children who have parts must stay all day.
Okay. If children have parts in the Christmas play tonight, they're staying all day long. We're going to feed them lunch and dinner, okay? Can't beat that. So, and you get rid of them all day. That's even an extra bonus. So all children stay all day. They're going to take care of them all day long, feed them lunch and dinner. Okay. Who has a birthday or an anniversary? Anybody? How did y'all get so lucky? I got three grandkids that have birthdays in December. They break me in December.
And two daughter-in-laws.
That's right. All right. Well, let's stand up. Find somebody, shake their hand, tell them Merry Christmas and glad to see them this morning. Okay, let's find our way back to our seats. They don't pay attention to you either. Let's find our way back to our seats. You can be seated. Find your way back to your seats. No. Oh, they're getting there. You remember when we had COVID and nobody would touch each other? And we thought we'd never be able to shake hands or hug necks again. Alan Dean, what are you doing, Alan Dean?
Now, I got to say something about that. That took me back about 35 years right there, watching people swat wasps off of windows.
I thought he was in the Pentecostal church. The Holy Spirit didn't grab him. Hey, during Thanksgiving, when Becky got ready to go home after Thanksgiving, in her Thanksgiving box, this little pouch was in her Thanksgiving stuff. It's a little money pouch. It's got $1,000 in it. So. about ten hands went up. No, it does have a little bit of money in it, but if it belongs to anybody, let us know. I think it's got a few dollars in it, so if it's yours, see Miss Becky, and she'll give it to you, okay? So if you recognize it, let us know, okay? All right, that's all I got to say. Whose time is it?
It's me.
Okay.
And you. Won't you stand? I think, yeah. Yep. Page 100, or the TV. It this morning. That's a hard song to sing. I messed up way more than you did. Oh, Come All Ye Faithful, page 89. Verse. Thank you. We need to just do that one Sunday. The whole Sunday. All the whole time. Nothing against your preaching. But we just need to do that one whole Sunday. You may be seated. Yep, the 25th. There you go. All right, choir, would you please get on the stage?
It's truly the most wonderful time of the year. But it's more than just tinsel and lights that stir our hearts with a sense of wonder. Christ has come, a Savior wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger.
Celebrate the child who is alive.
Night.
The familiar words of Isaiah were first spoken in a world without hope, to a people longing for a deliverer, waiting for a redeemer. Centuries of silence would pass before God. In his perfect time, he would send his only begotten Son as a light into the darkness to remove every doubt, fulfill every prophecy, and satisfy every longing.
Jesus, for to set thy feet.
silent night in Bethlehem, God spoke, and angels rejoiced, and the world would never be the same again. Shepherds would worship and kings would bow, and darkness would tremble, all because a baby came.
Up in the night sky of stars.
Emmanuel, God with us, the word of the Father come to dwell in our midst. This child of Bethlehem is our hope. He is our salvation, our Redeemer. Infant Lamb of God lying in a manger, He is Christ the Lord.
Thank you.
just as believers have for over 2,000 years, once again we come into a season with a sense of expectation, seeking to experience the wonder of the incarnation in all its glory. To think that Christ would give up his throne in heaven for you and for me defies our human understanding. Is it any wonder we celebrate? Christ has come. This is the story of Christmas. Thank you, choir. Thank you, Becky Lucas, for leading the choir. Great message there. And thank you, Graysons, for turning us on and off when we needed to be turned on and off. They have worked hard since September, practicing every Sunday after church while you go home and eat. They have stayed and worked. Very pretty, very beautiful, great message. Thank you so very much. And thank you for being here today to hear them as they presented the Christmas story through song. Jesus left his home in heaven. As I listen to them sing the Christmas story, that just always amazes me. I just cannot imagine Jesus, God himself, choosing to leave heaven's glory to come to earth in any form or fashion to live among us, but to come as a baby, to be born in a lowly manger, to dwell among mankind, to choose to do that, knowing that he would have to go to an old rugged cross to be crucified and shed his blood so that you and I could have eternal life. As I preach that and as I think about that over and over at Christmas time and at Easter time, that story just always amazes me that God would choose to do that, to leave a place as gorgeous and as great as heaven could be, to choose to come live among us. Thank you for being here today. I hope that you'll return time and time again this Christmas to hear the Christmas story, to live the Christmas story, to be a part of the Christmas story. And you saw this morning, you heard this morning, you heard the choir sing this morning. The children are going to present a different Christmas story this afternoon. I hope that you'll come and see them and hear them and watch them and their amazement as they present their Christmas story. It's always fun to see them. Christmas, children are Christmas. And so I hope that you'll come and support them and be here and watch them and see their take on the Christmas story this afternoon. If you're here this morning and you don't know Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, we're going to sing something. I don't know. Have we got anything picked out?
Have thine own way.
Okay. We're going to stand and sing a couple verses of Have Thine Own Way. If you just need to come, you can stand. Go ahead and stand. Ricky, if you'll come on up here. And if you need to come down front and pray, if you need to come talk to me, or if you need to talk to Jamie or anyone else, just come on down here, and I'll be down front. We'd love to have talk with you. You need to move a church membership, or if any decision you need to make of any kind, I'll be down front. I'll be glad to talk to you about that. So, Jamie, let's go ahead and get started.
Have thine own way, Lord.
I